Hi guys, welcome to another vlog. I'm sure you've gathered from the sun that I'm no longer in London. I'm in Israel for the first time. I'm super excited. I arrived yesterday and I spent the day with Ben and his brother, and then I'm starting my vlog today. So I'm gonna be doing a lot of touristy stuff this week, and let's explore Tel Aviv and other places together. So first stop this morning, Shuk HaCarmel, and we're gonna eat here and just explore. Is it the most famous markets in Tel Aviv?
I think.
Okay. Figs. Oh, there's the turmeric, all the spices. We got our first purchase at the market, pomegranates and orange juice. Interesting. Try it. It's kind of not nice, but what do you think? Now we're sitting at a fish and chip shop, which I know, coming from London, I shouldn't be eating fish and chips first, but apparently it's like highly recommended, and it's the best fish and chips Ben's brother has ever had. So we're gonna try this, and then we're gonna try loads of other food because we're starving, and what better to do than eat everything at a market. I'm really excited to try this. Okay, here it is. Oh, they even have, is this mushy peas? That's so English. Also, this is a small portion, just in case anyone comes here. The fish and chips were fantastic. It was really super crunchy, which I love. And the mushy peas had mint in it. I don't know if that's a normal thing, but it was really nice. Anyways, now we are gonna go off to our next food stop. But yeah, oh, I just wanted to say about the dogs. Everyone seems to have so many dogs here. It's actually like very dog friendly city. We've come to our second spot, which I found on Insta, and it's called M25. What are we eating here?
Arayes.
And what is that?
It's pita with minced meat.
Okay, I'm excited. But there seems to be a queue and like a waiting list, so I suppose that's a good sign, but not since we're in a rush. So this is it, meat market butcher shop. It's called M25, and it won some Time Out awards. This looks so yum. Wow, look at that. Yum. OMG, it's boiling though, like it's actually so hot. Okay, that looks so good.
Didn't we get tuna?
It also smells so yum. Okay, I'm taste testing it for you. Ben says it's the best one he's ever tried. This is so good. It's like crispy, juicy. So yeah. Look at all the breads, this is literally heaven. I want it all. Look how good, we walked past here earlier, never mind. It was halab with schnitzel, aubergine, matkoufa. Looks so good. You have to come here for the food. Too much sun. Yeah, you have to come here for food. This hill trip is gonna be as much of a surprise for me as it is for you watching, because I don't know anything that's happening until the day before it happens. So today we are going to the desert. I'm so excited, but yeah, we're going to the desert. He planned I don't know how many days, but so this is basically what the vlog is gonna be about, and I cannot wait. Our first lunch, we got a chicken salad and some grilled chicken with Cajun potatoes, and look at our view. Okay, you can't really see so clearly, but trust me, it's amazing. Anyways, I'm gonna eat and then show you around later. So this is the main lobby of the hotel, and now we're driving to our room. So we just got to our room and I'm super super excited to show you guys. This is such a cute hotel and I feel like I'm dreaming. Okay, so here's our room. Little room tour. Should we start with the bathroom? Look how cute this is. It's all super like authentic deserty vibes. I feel like the colors, tones, I like the floor. There's a nice big bath. This is my outfit of today because we came quite late, so it's like cute. But just actually, if you come here, it's quite cold in the evening. So like it was chilly now and it's like 4 o'clock. Okay, so here's our room. It's super spacious, but look at the best part. We have this view. Like, I literally can't get over it. Also, we have our own little decking area with the beds, and then look at that view. There's an infinity pool right over there. Some of the rooms also have their own pool, but I think that's like literally the highlight, the infinity pool over the desert. But look how nice. Also, we have to keep our doors closed because the, what are they? Like the deers, but they're not deers. They're like mountain goat type things, and they like crawl up and apparently they eat everything in your room, so yeah. I hope the animals come up here. We saw some earlier down there by the pool. Okay, we're leaving to go see the sunset, so we put on our robes, and I just love this place because it's like a, it's, you're out in the wild, but like everyone's just walking around in their robes like it's a little village, you know? Like if we're in a Bedouin village. Wow, 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 wow. Wow, guys, can you see this? I hope you see this as beautifully as I do, because this is stunning. So this is where we were today when there was sun, and then we had lunch. That's a crater. Look how insane this view is. Apparently the sunset is really nice here. Sunrise. So the sunset's over there, but the sun rises over there. So stay tuned for tomorrow morning when we wake up at 5 a.m. for that. He's not very excited, but I am. Okay, from here you see it a lot clearer, the crater, and then like look at that. Even though it's no sunset, just the pink sky is beautiful. So sorry, my mistake, it's not actually a crater. So we just looked it up and this is the world's largest erosion cirque. I've never heard of it before, but it looks so amazing, and to have a hotel looking over it, it's incredible. We just swam, sorry about my messy button, we just swam in the indoor-outdoor pool, and then we had to get out, and it's so, so cold because it's outside. Now we're going to the spa! Look how quickly the sun has set. It's literally dark now, and it is not even 6 o'clock. What time is it? 5:20. It's 5:20. We went into the sauna and then we stayed here for a bit, and now I think we're gonna go back to the pool. So okay, we came back out to the pool. It's pitch black dark right now. Look at the stars. Okay, we're gonna go for a little swim, even though we froze to death last time, but you know. so cool. Okay, we're walking back to our room now. It's really cold, but also isn't it so cute? It's literally like we're walking through a village with all the rooms being like independent bungalows. Oh my god. We couldn't find, like, we don't know which way we walked, and Ben, we were like, oh shit, we accidentally left our door open, but he actually walked in on someone else's house. Good evening. So I'm gonna quickly show you guys my OOTN. This is it. I'm wearing some gold sandals and a dress that I felt was kind of like deserty vibes because of the like colors, the green, the gray, the brown. It's just super cute. So this is my date night outfit. Let's go to dinner. Is basically a buffet for starter, and there is so much good food. Like, the lighting is bad in here, but like, I got hummus with mint, sweet potato, like grilled sweet potato, some other salad. There's like more, we're gonna go back. I got like beef carpaccio with I don't even know what it was. Like, there's just so many like sashimi things. Like, it just looks like a very, very good buffet. This is one of the best souffles I've ever had. Now we're going to sleep. That was the end of day one here in the desert, and I'm excited for tomorrow, so stay tuned. We're going to wake up at 5:30 to watch the sunrise, and then we have another surprise. What's my next surprise? Okay, he's gonna tell me off camera, and you guys are gonna find out tomorrow. See you. Good morning! It's 5:30 and I'm way too excited for this because I just opened the curtains and it already looks so pretty and I can't wait. So I'm just wearing Ben's hoodie and some jeans and sneakers because I know it's still gonna be freezing like last night or worse. I'm really tired, but I love things like this. Okay, so let's go. What time is it fully? So guys, so right now it is 5:36. We woke up at 5:25 and it's fully risen at 5:57. But sunrises and sunsets go so much quicker than people realize. So you need to let's go quickly. This is where we got lost last night because it's such a maze. Okay guys, I'm gonna show my phone because this is not as good, but seemingly we're the only crazy people, as Ben says, because like nobody's here to watch this. What's going on? I thought this was the highlight. Oh, there's like one couple over there. Okay. So this is 10 minutes later at 5:46. Now people are arriving. So that was most of the sunrise. It's crazy because you guys can, oops, I'm zoomed in, see me clearer than the sun. My phone seemed to take better pictures. I don't know if it's, I can't do the settings, or I read on Google the exposure is kind of crazy when from day to, from night to day. So we just watched most of it and now we're gonna go back to our room and like sit on our beds in the garden area to watch the rest. I'm so happy. It was literally the most dreamy experience. I like started tearing up because it's just so magical. It's the clearest sunrise I've ever seen and it was just so beautiful, like right in the middle coming up. Like, it's just such a wow experience, and I don't understand why people like honestly can't get out of bed for things like this. Did you like it though?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good. Here are the rooms with the pools, so like the animals can come up to you. And then there's ours with like the garden bit. And like this is like a chilling pit where we were yesterday, and they can light a fire. I just fell off a stone. That's the main building, and that's the sunrise. Okay, pool time. Just wearing shorts and a crop. Oh no, actually we're going to breakfast first. Let's go see how breakfast is. It's only 7 a.m. and I feel super awake, surprisingly. We were just walking to breakfast and look, we spotted the animals. I need to find out the proper name for them. It started with an O. Because they're not mountain goats, they're something else. There's so many of them! Wow! Hi, baby! Look how funny. They won't attack me, right? Curious about me. Uh-oh, do you see him? Do you see that? That was very scary, wasn't it?
No.
Oh my god, babe, 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 he's gonna run for me. Guys, I'm very scared right now.
Go like this.
I don't have food. What if they attack me?
Feed the big one. What attack? She can just give him food, poor animal.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Give him food. What's that thing he's doing with his tongue?
He's going for it, he's going for it. He's going for it, he's trying to make his move on the female. Ben was laughing because it attacked my bag, but actually he didn't realize it was my bag. Babe, your phone is in there and everything. Naughty boy. Is everything okay?
I think so.
Now he's trying to feed him. Don't be mean, he's scared of you now. Breakfast time! Guys, how cute is this? They have trick or treat printed on the coffee. And look how nice our table is. We have our champagne, our juices, our fresh bread, everything with a view. Look at that breakfast view. Like, can you get over that? I don't think so. Cheers! Finished our breakfast and it was actually really, really yummy. Like, the pancakes are one of the best pancakes I've had in a hotel buffet, so I really enjoyed it. And now we're out at the pool. It's like around 8:30. What time is it? Maybe 9 o'clock already, and there's literally nobody else at the pool. I'm really shocked. Like, we saved our bed, as you do. thinking it's gonna be packed, because yesterday when we got here there was no beds left in the sun. So now we got this like really nice big white bed, and we literally have full sun view, so it's like amazing. And it's so, so peaceful here. And literally just two people came and sat right next to us. Oh. Here's the view, which I still can't get over. Differences between a girl's bag and a guy's bag. It's literally like half the size. Anyways, we're finished at Beresheet and we are going to the next stop now, which is...
Okay, you're just gonna have to wait and see. So I'm super excited for this. It was another one of the top of my bucket list. So oops, I'm accidentally zooming in. See you soon.
Guys, this is so exciting. So as you just saw from the sign, well, we're driving, but as you just saw from the sign, we have just reached sea level and we're still going down on all these windy roads. So if you have any sort of like queasiness or what's it called when you're kind of like car sickness, if you have any sort of car sickness or something, definitely take some tablets for this drive. But yeah, the Dead Sea is minus 430 meters below sea level, so that's pretty crazy. No, I'm so excited to see. Oh, I just gave away our next destination. Yeah, surprise, we're going to the Dead Sea.
We arrived at the Dead Sea and it was quite a drive, but yeah, we checked into our hotel, all fine and well. As you can see, the sun has already is pretty much setting, but since we're like in a valley kind of thing, we don't have much sun anymore, but it's okay. I'm still super excited to try the sea. Ben has already done it a couple of times or been in it, and he says like you literally float, which is obviously what everyone says, but like I just can't believe, like, you know, how will it be lying back? But I'm super excited. So first stop will be the mushrooms. Yeah, just a little side note, if anyone's coming here, the hotel we're staying at is called, oh look how pretty, I don't know if you can see because it's quite misty. Do you know which way we're going, babe? The hotel we're staying at, it's called Spa Club, I think. It was highly rated on booking.com, but I personally do not recommend it because of, like, we literally spent 2 hours eating and waiting for check-in, and it was super unorganized, the lobby, everything, just generally displeased. But it's okay, still excited for the rest and to try see. And tomorrow we might be going to what's it called? Masada? Tomorrow we might be going to the Masada temple, so I'm really excited about that too. Let's get to the sea. Okay, we're kind of off-roading, but Google Maps tells us it's somewhere there, so hopefully we find our way. We're in. Wow, this is all salt. It's literally rock hard salt. Also, look how pretty that is. Oh my goodness. And it's so quiet. There's no fan. Okay, I'm gonna be doing my first impressions of the first time floating. I really hope, I'm expecting big things here. Okay, first of all, temperature is fantastic. It hurts your feet, and I have the tiniest like paper cuts on my finger, and it stings like a bitch. Ah! Ooh, that hurts your bum. My body is literally floating. Like, I'm not even pushing my bum up. Oh my goodness. I can't even go down. I'm trying to push myself down and it doesn't work. You're actually floating like if you're on a thing. Wow. This is so fun. This is so fun. I love it. I really love this. Wow. It actually feels like you're on a lilo. It's like you're waving yourself, but you're like, you know what I mean? Like, you know when you're on a lilo and it's like you feel heavy, I don't know.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Okay, I'm just gonna keep having fun. Bye guys. Whoa, you can literally not sink. Okay, I'm gonna try to sit. This hurts. Later. Good morning guys, it's 9:30 and we're
Sorry about the bad sound quality, guys. I didn't realize how windy it was until I started editing this vlog, so I'm gonna do a little voiceover on these bits that you can't hear clearly. Why are people leaving their trash behind? If you brought it with you, bring it back with you. Just put it in a bin. Don't litter a beautiful place like this, or any place really.
Oh, it's a bit cooler than yesterday, but it's still the perfect temperature. Last night we went to kind of the mall and stuff. It's honestly, there's not that much to do here, so if you do come to the Dead Sea, I
would recommend only staying 1 or max 2 days. We found our length of stay was absolutely perfect because we did everything there was to do in just 1 night and 2 afternoons, which is basically just going to the beach and floating in the sea. And just a heads up, it's November and we found it so hot. It was definitely the hottest temperature that we had in the whole trip in Israel, and presumably because it's in the mountains and it's the lowest point. So just, if you're going in the summer, be cautious.
Should we flip? So much fun! Floating! Okay, now I need to figure out how to go down. Whoosh! We're at the mushrooms. So here's a close-up view. They're literally just like salt. What is it called? Oh, it really hurts. I think that's how I got loads of cuts on my bum yesterday, because I was sitting on it and it's really rough. As you can see, it's literally just like a... ow. Anyways. Look, it's the heart mushroom, guys. Also, look at this. It's pure salt. Okay, that might be self-explanatory, the Dead Sea, salt sea, but like, so amazing! And by the way, look, it's getting a lot busier, so people do know about this. So I would come early, like around 9 a.m., or come in the evening. But of course, lighting is better in the morning. We're trying to figure out how to swim, because you can't swim, you just have to like push yourself.
Also, we can't swim because we have one hand.
What? But when I tried to swim on my stomach earlier with 2 hands, it didn't work either, because you're just kind of, you're trying to defeat. By the way, we keep calling them mushrooms because to find this place you have to go on Google Maps and put in mushrooms. I don't know if it will come up in English, but if you write mushrooms in Hebrew, right? What was it called?
Mushrooms, I think it was.
Okay. P.S. It tastes very bad.
Very salty.
No, but it's not even salty, it just tastes gross.
Because of the salt, I think, no? I mean, because it's so salty.
Like, it didn't taste like a super duper salty... do you know what I mean? Like, it actually tastes...
It's just so salty,
a bit
spicy.
Nasty. My propeller. Okay, hi guys. So we just showered in the, as you say in Hebrew, sugar water. So non-salty water. And we're gonna be going into the sea. So we're on the beach now. We just like did our little walk through and left. It's super, like it really gives you thigh burn and everything. So be careful. Keep, like, carry something that you can put maybe in between your thighs or something. And look how beautiful the sea is. It's so clear. We realized there's like a lot of just older people here though. So I don't know if it's because it's not really holiday time, so it's mainly old people come on holiday, but yeah. Anyways, we're gonna do something exciting, which is also famous for the Dead Sea. We're gonna cover ourselves in mud. So last night at the mall we bought some mud. They sell it everywhere. It has minerals for rejuvenating the skin, so I hope I look young after this. It's fun. And I'm using my phone to film now because I don't want to get mud on my camera. And we have some on our noses. Hopefully it works like blackhead strips. It's drying up now, so it's getting kind of hard and crispy. Look how beautiful the sea is behind us. It looks actually like we're in some tropical place, no?
Yeah.
Anyways, let's go wash this off.
Goodbye to the Dead Sea. Off to our next stop.
So we've arrived, we're waiting for our cable car at Masada, which is a UNESCO World Heritage Site, which was a fortress. Okay, so it was a fortress for the Jewish freedom fighters against the Romans. So yeah, I'm really excited to see it. It was literally only a 15-minute drive from the Dead Sea, and I am looking forward to it. Looking at our map, this is what it looks like on top here on this mountain. We have the Western Palace, the Byzantine Church, Southern Water Cistern. The water cisterns are super interesting, so when we get there we'll talk about that. But and there's a snake path, so you can actually walk up here. People hike up this, but like that's just not what I'm on for right now. Yeah, if you haven't watched our South of France road trip, that was pretty intense on hiking. So you can go watch that after this vlog, but oh, there's some shaded areas. That's actually really good. And look at this. They have water filling taps with cold water. We brought our own bottle, but this is great. And look at all the shaded area. So when you're walking around exploring, you can have some shadow because it's very hot up here. Okay, let's start our tour. Following you, tour guide Ben. Look in here, which is closed off, presumably to keep it safe from erosion and people walking all over and stuff. But you can see the leftover mosaic. Okay, so this is one of the most impressive parts. This is a Herodian water cistern by the Byzantine monks. So think about this, this is like more than 2,000 years ago. They've made 12 cisterns that can hold up to 40,000 cubic meters of water. They build dams and special systems to get the water into the cisterns, and then the animals could bring it around on the top of the mountain. That's just crazy. So this is the Columbarium Tower. They rose doves here. That's so cool. So it was a tower that was used, Ben is shading me, so cute. It was a tower used for a watchtower, but they also had several hundred niches to, so doves could breed, roost, in which the doves roosted. And the doves supplied meat for Masada's inhabitants. Isn't that cool? So they wrote, and then also fertilizer for their agricultural crops. That's so interesting. Yeah. Then all of their little nesting areas, the watchtower area. So this is one of the oldest synagogues found.
In Italian, corvo. Corvo.
Look at this, guys, it's literally a palm tree forest. Palm trees as far as your eye can see. Okay, we're at our third and final stop, Jerusalem. And we were supposed to go to Shuk, what was it?
Machne Yehuda.
Shuk Machne Yehuda. But unfortunately, because we're here on a Friday, it's closed today. Oh no, sorry. It closes at 3 p.m. on Fridays and it's closed on Saturdays. So make sure you check the opening times, which is a shame because we missed it, but it's okay. We're just walking through and it's actually humongous. So, I mean, I don't know if it is any good, but there's so many options. And also I've seen from my little research that the food here is insane as well. So highly recommend, although I haven't been able to try anything myself.
Spa time!
Time.
Oh, Hi guys, so I'm back from the spa and I thought I'll give you a little room tour because this hotel is so beautiful again, so why not share it with you guys? So you walk into Don't Mind Ben Lying on the Bed Like a Lazy Poo. Look, you walk into this beautiful bedroom. Look how beautiful this bed is with the chaise longue. Shabbat shalom, by the way. Anyways, so we got a bottle of kava, and then look at our bathroom. How beautiful is this with this amazing bath? I cannot wait to get in. Also, look how pretty the floor is here. Loving it. And I'm gonna show you the outside later because it's a super beautiful hotel. Anyways, we're gonna figure out what we're gonna have for dinner because it's quite late, and since we got to the hotel late, we ate recently, so we don't really want to go to dinner here because dinner, Shabbat dinner finishes at 8:30, which is in like half an hour. So we have to find another restaurant open in Jerusalem on Friday night. I will let you know where we find. Good morning, guys. I'm in the entrance to our room and I'm just catching you guys up while Ben gets ready, you know, guys, taking their time. Anyways, this is my outfit of this morning, of this breakfast. Basically, yesterday we didn't end up going to the Shabbat dinner because it would have been a waste since we weren't hungry at all. It is a shame we didn't go because obviously it would have been nice. But yeah, so we ended up like really late walking around to see. There were a couple of restaurants that are open on Shabbat, but we found this like kind of like food court and music area. So there was like a whole thing and it's like literally 2 minutes walk from the hotel. So we ate there and then we walked back and it was really cute. So isn't this so beautiful? So this is the entrance where there's four rooms and it's so cute. Like it's just so aesthetic and beautiful. I love this type of vibe. But yeah, let's go to breakfast. I'm super hungry and super excited to try because I love the breakfast at Beresheet and it's the same hotel group. Ooh, it's sunny today. Look how cute this little seating area is here. And that's basically the main area of the hotel. But look how aesthetic this hotel is. Like, isn't that just stunning? Literally looks like out of a catalog. And these hanging lights. Oh, look, it's Ben. Hello. I just love these like black details and the gold and the accents. So here's our powerful lion. And that's the breakfast. I'm gonna show you around the buffet later. It's just kind of busy now and also we were hungry. It's really interesting. Ben was explaining everything to me. So actually that's a heads up for anyone coming to Jerusalem. If you're not aware about Friday and Saturday being Shabbat. And well, this hotel anyways is run kosher. So that means there won't be any hot food that has to be made in the morning. So everything here is like mezze platters or grills or something that's worked on a hot plate. Like Ben was explaining the system to me so that they don't use electricity in the morning. So I think it's really interesting and I can't wait to dig in. And this is, what is that?
Jaffna.
And it's Yemeni, no? And then you eat it with tomato and egg. And then look at the challah, my favorite part. Look at this heavenly challah selection. Pool time! The pool views from the rooftop of the hotel. This is actually where we ate last night. So we're just gonna enjoy the sun and then go for our sightseeing. Look how nice this spa is. Like even the ceiling is beautiful with the gold, and look at those chairs in like bamboo and stuff. It's just so stunning. And also the tiles are gold. Let's go to the sauna. We've just checked out and it's around 3, oh my goodness, It's 4 o'clock already. It's 4 o'clock, which is great because I thought I'd be a bit roasting since I'm wearing like a black silk shirt, a long sleeve. It might be a bit hot in the sun, but actually not because the sun is setting soon. So that's great. Can't wait to do all our sightseeing. Lego!
So this part I didn't actually vlog very well because as it was a holy day, I didn't want to film while people were praying, but it was actually very nice since there weren't that many tourists, so we pretty much had the whole place to ourselves while we were walking around and exploring. I definitely will be going back and doing a proper tour of Jerusalem, so do stay tuned for that vlog.
What is this? It's the station of cross. Part of it in the Christian, the way.
Here I'm at a view on the top and we can see the quarters of Jerusalem. So there on the right is the Jewish quarter, we have the Muslim quarter, the Christian quarter is behind there, as you can see the church, and then there's the Armenian quarter over there. Look, we're eating some Armenian, what's it called? Armenian, can't remember, with an S. And it's wraps stuffed with mince and tzatziki and things like that. We are in the Greek quarter of Jerusalem. So we just walked through the markety area and we stopped in this, it's called Beresheet. And the food smelled good, so we just decided to stop it. Okay, so now we got some shish tok with rice. Smells and looks great, so I would recommend this restaurant. Mmm, it's so succulent.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to eat and then head off back to Tel Aviv, so I'll see you guys later. So this is basically where we ate. In the Christian quarter, and I just love this city. The old city of Jerusalem is so full of culture and I've really enjoyed exploring it. Sorry, it's getting noisy, so I'll chat later. Okay, so this is Jaffa Gate and I'm just showing you the wall that surrounds the whole of the old city, which is really interesting. Look at this. This is our breakfast. We got some shakshuka, a toasty with cheese, pesto, tomato, olives. I have banana and date smoothie, like a banana lassi with date. And what are you drinking? Something with mango. We're in Yafo, and this is Ben's favorite breakfast place, and I'm super excited to eat this because I'm starving. It's actually kind of lunchtime right now. And we also ordered one other thing that we saw the lady behind us had it, so stay tuned for that. Okay, bon appetit. Wow. This is like a sesame bagel or something, no? Okay, we've just put down our little mat. And we are going to watch the sunset. Look how beautiful. I feel like a really cool vibe.
Mm-hmm.
It's such a cool vibe.
Let's get warm.
Hi guys, so I hope you enjoyed watching that sunset with me. We are now walking to dinner. We went home for a bit, just like tidied, relaxed, showered, and now we're going out for an early dinner because our lunch was the last time we ate, or our breakfast you saw me eat. Anyways, we're going to a restaurant, I'll show you what it is, but I just wanted to show you around the Yafo area as well, which is really nice because it has all these little streets with lights and like music. It's very lively and loads of bars, restaurants, but it's like never ending. So I definitely recommend. Also, at the weekend, it gets so packed, like it's impossible to get a table there. Look how pretty our dinner set.
Okay, so we're sitting at the restaurant. It's called Ramesses, and I just got my cocktail. So. Oh, that's actually really refreshing. This restaurant is a really cool concept, and that's why Ben brought me to it, because the menu changes all the time and they do like different things. So like a curry would be changed into like, I don't know how to explain, but yeah, I'm really excited to get our food. We ordered a couple of things. Also the other day when we came, it was packed, and apparently it's like always really, really busy, and they're huge. They also have another section over there. So it's really, really big. Luckily, we are here at 7, which is really early, like European time to eat, because like I said earlier, we only had our breakfast today and we have other stuff to do this evening. So yeah, if you do want to come here, make sure you reserve in advance. Okay, so first of all, we got a baked potato with some grilled onions. What's the base, babe?
Sorry.
So what's on it? Okay.
Onions and everything.
That's just a bomb of flavors. What is the white thing though?
No idea.
Wow. This is salmon skewer with some coconut red spicy curry and challah. So it's like a Israeli twist on an Indian curry. It looks so good and smells so good again. So I haven't updated you since we went to watch the sunset at the beach the other day, but it was so beautiful and I just love being at sea or like by the beach and like hearing the ocean and stuff like right now. So I'm sure you've gathered I'm at the beach again, but this time I'm at the beach in Herzliya and it's a lot more calm here and it's also really, really nice. So I'm here because Ben is at uni, so I decided to come to the beach while he was at uni since the past 2 days I've done like all my work. So yeah, here's the beach in Herzliya. Like, can I please remind you guys that it's November and I was literally just napping and you know that smell of burgers or like chips and burgers at the beach, like, or at the pool or something, like, you know there's like a specific smell of like cool beach burgers. Does anyone get what I mean? Like, you know when you're staying at a hotel or something and you order a burger. Anyway, so that's what woke me up and it smells so good. But I guess I'm not hungry, so I shouldn't really order anything. I'm sorry, this vlog has probably been a bit messy because this whole trip was a surprise for me. So, like, obviously I knew I was coming to Israel, but like Ben planned every single detail of it, so I didn't like know anything and I couldn't really like explain what was going on. Also, I was trying to enjoy because I hadn't seen him in a while and like it's my first time in Israel as well, so like I've just been taking it all in and it's just such a beautiful place. Anyways, I'm gonna keep tanning and reading and just chilling. Trying to swim and I'm just chilling here with some drinks and we ordered some food. The sun is about to set too, so that's gonna be cool. Oh, they're already coming back. I guess they gave up. Another sunset, but unfortunately today it's not that clear because of the clouds. Oh my goodness, it's freezing. Did someone whistle? Is our food there? Our food is up there.
With fries.
No shit. But why did you say it's so famous?
I'm gonna take
here?
You a piece, huh?
It's, why is it so famous? It's just
really
very
good
known.
Here.
People always eat that.
Actually, quite cute. Welcome to my last day in Tel Aviv. We are going to Sarona Market now, which could be the equivalent of like Borough Market,
in London, and there's a market in Barcelona as well. It's quite loud here, so I'm just gonna show you around. But it's indoor, so that's super cool. And there's a big mix between restaurants, food shops, and etc. Like drinks, bars, blah blah blah. And there's like a whole variety. So there's like really good cuisine, but there's also more snacky stuff and sandwiches and stuff like that. I also like that it's an indoor vibe with music and stuff. So I suppose that's really handy if bad weather. Does it ever become bad weather? Or if it's just really hot outside, you can come here. You must be thinking, wow, she's eating so much on this trip, but Israel is known for their good food, and wow, look at that pizza. He's eating, it's so full. Okay, so they are known for their really good food, and they have loads of markets. So unfortunately we didn't try the food at the markets in Jerusalem, but I'm definitely going to go back to Jerusalem in the future. It was just that I was supposed to leave last week, so we condensed everything into a very short time. Anyways, let's go try this food because I am starving.
So we started off with this Moroccan stew type thing, which came highly recommended on Instagram. But although we liked it, it was just far too filling considering we wanted to try many things. And another place that came highly recommended was this meat bar burger, but I wasn't in the mood for burgers.
Look at this, it's called Fiori Fresh Pasta Bar, and you can literally choose all your fresh pastas. Look how nice this looks. They're so cute. I think I'd love those. So many amazing places I want to try. So, I don't know, where should we try next? Do you want cookies? I'm making you cookies later. Fish shop, we're not trying, because Ben doesn't eat fish, but he does sometimes. But we're trying the most recommended places. So actually, fish shop was one of the most recommended places. So if you are into seafood, definitely try that out. Wasn't this at the... at the buffet in the hotel for breakfast?
Yeah.
So what is it exactly?
Sesame seeds.
Sesame seeds? Pure sesame seeds. Which one's the best one to try? Premium chocolate. Oh, coconut.
Premium chocolate.
Do you want some?
Yes.
It's an interesting texture, kind of grainy. It tastes like sesame crackers. Look how cute this aesthetic is. Like, it's such a nice place to just chill. So this is a really famous chef in Israel, and apparently he goes by the name The Magician, and we're ordering a shawarma pizza from him right now, and this is his cookbook. It looks so nice. Like, if I knew someone that would use this, I would totally buy it as a gift.
YouTube.
This literally feels like the fluffiest pizza ever. Like, I can feel the bread in my hand, and he layered it. It's literally insane. Okay, that big thing sticking out is an aubergine. Like, he literally just kept layering it, which is the best, because usually, you know, you have to keep topping up the sauce, or you have to, like, I don't know, you get to the end, which is all veg or something like that. So I'm so excited to eat this. Let's take our first bite. I don't even know where to bite. So big. This is only the second thing we're trying as well, so it's gonna get quite filling, I think.
In me? No.
Wow. It's like a fried aubergine.
Bite anymore?
The pizza bread. I'm a big fan.
just so juicy. Look how fluffy that pizza bread is. Okay, so we also ordered a falafel pizza, but he added a falafel on top of this shawarma pizza, and it's so good. So I'm at the airport now. Yesterday after, oh, it was actually 2 days ago. After that shawarma, we wanted to go get dessert, or we wanted to try at least one other thing, but we couldn't. I was in such a food coma. I honestly could barely, I didn't know if I should sit or stand, but I could barely walk to the car, and then we napped when we got home because we were like both in a food coma, like major food coma vibes. I don't know whether it's because it was the first meal of our day and it was just super heavy, or it was just a very heavy loaded pizza. Totally recommend, even though I struggled for the rest of the day. But then we went out, and like honestly, when they say the nightlife in Tel Aviv is good, it is insane. Like, just it's good vibes all around. But I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog and enjoyed discovering Israel with me. So give it a big thumbs up and stay tuned for the next one. And make sure you press that subscribe button and of course the notification bell to be notified whenever I upload.